Hello everybody and welcome to our second assembly. Last week's assembly was all about emotions and feelings, and this week's assembly is about empathy. Putting ourselves into a different situation and thinking about how other people feel. Empathy, what does that actually mean? It's the ability to understand how someone else is feeling or to understand the situation they're in. It's the ability to put yourself in somebody else's shoes and to understand the way the situation might make somebody else feel. A little more kindness and a little less judgment. Sometimes we need to not judge others and stop and put ourselves into the same situation, or to put ourselves into somebody else's can help us understand other people's lives and to develop empathy. A whole range of characters, places. If we're able to read these, we can transport ourselves into different situations. We can think about how other characters are feeling. We can think about different places across the world. The reading is a great way to empathise, and then we can bring that into real life. Read, connect and act. Lots of reading helps us develop empathy skills. Then we're able to connect with the characters, and then we can act in real life and put those things that we've learned through reading in our books into practice. I'm going to share with you a story called The Invisible Boy. I want you to have a think during the story about how the characters supported each other and why the boy thought of himself as a...
The Invisible Boy, written by Trudy Ludwig, illustrated by Patrice Bat. Can you see Brian, the invisible boy? Even Mrs. Carlotti has trouble noticing him in her classroom. She's too busy dealing with Nathan and Sophie. Nathan has problems with what Mrs. Carlotti calls volume control. He uses his outside voice inside too much. Sophie whines and complains when she doesn't get her way. Nathan and Sophie take up a lot of space. Brian doesn't. When the bell rings for recess, Mika and JT take turns choosing kids for their kickball teams. The best players get picked first, then the best friends of the best players, then the friends of the best friends. Only Brian is left, still waiting and hoping. JT glances in Brian's direction and just as quickly looks away. "We've got enough players for each team," he tells the others. "Let's play ball." In the cafeteria, Madison and her friends talk about her birthday party. "The rope swing over the pool was awesome," says JT. "Yeah, so is the water slide," adds Fiona. "That was the best pool party ever." "I'm so glad you guys had fun," says Madison. Everybody did except Brian. He wasn't invited. At choosing time, while the other kids play board games and read, Brian sits at his table doing what he loves to do best. He draws fire breathing dragons scaling tall buildings, space aliens locked in intergalactic battles, greedy pirates digging for treasure, and superheroes with the power to make friends wherever they go. On Monday morning, Mrs. Carlotti introduces Justin, a new student, to the class. Brian smiles shyly at him. Some of the other kids sneak looks at Justin, trying to figure out if he's cool enough to be their friend. They haven't quite made up their minds yet. At lunch, Madison and JT watch Justin eat with chopsticks. "What's that?" asks Madison as she points at Justin's food. "It's bulgogi." "Bul what?" "Bulgogi. It's Korean barbecue beef. My grandma made it for me. It's really good. Do you want to try some?" "There's no way I eat bulgogi." And the kids laugh. All of them. That is, except Brian. He sits there wondering which is worse, being laughed at or feeling invisible. The next day, when Justin goes to his cubby to put away his backpack, he notices a piece of paper with his name on it. "Justin, I thought the bulgogi looked good. Brian." At morning recess, Brian finds a piece of chalk on the ground and starts drawing away. You're Brian, right? Yeah. Thanks for the note. Hey, Justin, Emilio calls out from the tetherball court. You're up next. Sorry, I gotta go, says Justin. By the way, that's a really cool drawing, he adds before taking off. Back in class, Mrs. Carlotti asks the kids to team up in twos or threes for a special project. The kids scurry around the room to pair off. Brian heads toward Justin. I'm already with Justin, says Emilio. Find someone else. Brian looks at the floor, wishing he could draw a hole right there to swallow him up. Mrs. Carlotti said we can have up to three people in our group. We're only two. Come on, Emilio, let him work with us. Okay, I guess. Mrs. Carlotti gives the class directions for the project. Your assignment is to work together to write a story about what you see in that photograph. Use your imagination and have fun. Whoa, cool, says Emilio. What kind of people do you think would live in houses like that? I don't know, but I bet Brian could draw them to go with our story, says Justin. Brian smiles as he takes out his lucky pen. It's lunchtime again, Brian's least favourite part of the day. Another 20 long minutes of kids talking and laughing with everyone else but him. Brian, he hears someone shout. Hey Brian, over here. Brian turns and sees Justin waving him over. Emilio nods at Brian as he makes room for him at the table. Maybe, just maybe, Brian's not so invisible after all.
And put himself into Brian's shoes, and therefore he was able to offer support and friendship. And at the end of the story, Brian made good use of the excellent drawing skills and the imagination that he had. So by reading books, we can put ourselves into different situations. And then when we come across these things in school, we're able to think about the books and the stories that we've read, and that will help us to bring on and develop those empathy skills. So, thinking about putting ourselves in situations and thinking about reading and how that can help, I'm going to share with you part of a poem that was written by a boy called Archie, who was 8 years old. He thought about empathy and he thought about different situations and putting himself in other people's shoes. Listen carefully and think about the meaning behind the poem. I have never broken my leg, but I've fallen off my mountain bike and hurt my knee. I've never been stung by a wasp, but I've had a paper cut that made me wince in pain. I have never been starving, but I've heard my tummy rumble. I have never been homeless, but I've camped out under the trees. Sometimes our life situations can help us to empathise with others. Thinking about this one here, that you may have fallen and you may have hurt yourself and you know the pain that you've experienced. So if somebody was to fall and break their leg, you're able to empathise with how upset they are and how much pain they might be in. So sometimes our life experiences might help us to empathise with others. I'm going to send this poem home to you so that you can share it together. And then I want you to think about the meaning behind each statement in the poem. And see if you can add some to the end of the poem, thinking about things that you've never experienced, but things that might help you to empathise with those situations. Moving on from that, we want to also acknowledge in this assembly the achievements and the successes that have been happening across. across the school and at home. There are lots of you that have been logging on to My Maths, and the teachers have been monitoring that regularly. Next week's assembly, I'm going to share with you the class that has had the most activity on My Maths and used these and has been doing the activities that have been set by the teachers. We're also going to share our TT Rockstar battle results and also our most valuable players. This is something that we do on a Friday, and it's something that I'd like to continue. So you know that your hard work at home and in school is being acknowledged. So TT Rockstars, we had a battle set up, and you can see here year one and year two. Year two really worked hard and they won the battle there. We've got Miss Harris and Miss Ogarende's class next. You can see this was a really close battle. Both classes have been logging on, and you can see here that Miss Ogarende's class just beat them. Mr. Venner's class, Mrs. Marsh and Mrs. McMullen's class, again, lots of people logging on. A standout for Mr. Venner's class. Lots of you have been really supporting the battle, and you can see here a really big win. Mr. Bill's class, Miss Ball's class, again, a close battle, Mr. Bill's really overall. And then we've got children across the school who have been working really hard, and these are the most valuable players in the battle for each year group. And I'm going to read those and share them with you, and just to say a really big well done. So year one, we've got Millie and Ronnie. In year two, we've got Amber, Alex and Daniel. Miss Harris's class, Harriet, Roland, Bo, Lily and Isla. Miss Ogarende's class, Tammy, Daisy, Katerina. Mr. Benner's class, Jacob, Grace, Nishan. Mrs. Marsh's and Mrs. McMullen's class, Frankie, Rhea and Bailey. Miss Seville's class, Kieran and Zach. And Miss Ball's class, Joshkin, Royce, Alton and Natalia. These children have really worked hard to help with the points to win the battles. And next week, we're going to share people who have been logging on to TT Rockstars, and on our next battle, our most valuable players. So if your name is up here, or you know that you have logged on and you have been helping towards the battles, well done. And remember, it's really important to keep up with your times table skills. Last week I shared with you some of the work that had been done at home, and this week I want you to think about developing your empathy skills so you can make a difference. Think about what changes that you can make, whether it be in school, whether it be at home, whether it be at clubs. Think about that story and how just thinking about other people can really make a difference. I'm going to show you some of the work and achievements that have been sent into school this week. Thank you.